Hi, in this Lightboard session, we're going to talk about triggering your flows from a database. Now, databases are not real great from an integration perspective when we want to get a message out of a database. They're very good for storing data, they are amazing at persisting state, but in terms of talking to Mule, options are quite limited. So in those sort of situations where the web application or whatever application is putting data into a database and then we need to trigger on response to a row getting created or updated, then we've got to be the thing that polls the database and detects that change. So to that end, in the database connector, there is built-in scheduler mechanism, a scheduler that triggers on a time, and it can then, so if we're thinking about starting our flow, there is an on table row. Now, this is one of the things that you'll see when you look at the palette for the database connector. You'll see that this is sitting in there with the other operations. Now, the operations belong on the right-hand side of the dotted line in your flow. This one is an event source. So it is an event source. Now, the key thing here is that it is a row. So if it detects five new rows, your flow will get called five different times with one row each. Okay, so it is not a useful thing if you want to get maybe all of the rows together. We'll talk about that in a moment. But this built-in scheduling mechanism, so it's got something that will tick off on a particular schedule. So maybe every 10 seconds, every minute, every hour, or on a more complex repeating schedule. So if you want to trigger it at 3 o'clock in the morning, then there's an option for that. Now, it involves needing some sort of ability to talk out and detect whether or not those rows have changed. So to that end, it has built-in watermarking. So it's got watermark capabilities, and that will use the object store to keep a value so that it knows where it got up to last time. That by itself is not always necessary. We'll talk about that when we look at the alternatives to this. But this will get you each row, only the new ones, thanks to the watermarking capabilities, and then you can kick off whatever you need to do. So if you need to transform that row, you could use your Dataweave transform option there. And the end result of this is that you've processed that row, sent it off to another system, transformed the data, written a file, whatever you need to do, but it's only the one row, so your options for doing bulk operations are limited. Now, let's say you are going to get a lot of rows inserted and you don't want to do a round trip to some system every time you get one, just one row. We want to get all 100 rows instead. So to that end, instead of using the on-table row, we would use a scheduler, which will have that repeating task. Now, it doesn't pick up anything from the database, but its job is to call whatever you put in your event processes here. So your job at this point depends on whether you need a watermark or whether you can just do a select on the table. So if you can do a select on the table and know which ones are the new ones without having to store a watermark in the Mule object store, then so be it. You can just select the delta. But quite often you can't put extra columns into the table to store whether or not you've processed those records. In those situations, you might use a watermark. So if you need to do that, you would need to get that watermark using the object store. So you would do the object store retrieve, and that gets you your watermark. So you would bring in that watermark, and then from there, you can use one of the database operations to do a select. So do a select, and this will get you the delta of the rows. So this will give you 10 rows, 20 rows, whatever's changed since the last time you got your watermark stored into the object store. So very different number of records for these. If you want a single row, use on table row. If you want the delta or dozens, hundreds, thousands, whatever has been put in since last time, then use a scheduler, use the object store or something else maybe, but you need the previous value so that you can then select the delta. So those are the two main patterns for talking to a database and triggering your flow.